Hi everybody and welcome back to The Upside Dan. Today I'm going to be talking about one of my most anticipated movies of this year, Ghostbusters Afterlife. This is going to be a spoiler-free review, so you do not have to worry about any spoilers here. And before my rating, I will be talking about the 4DX experience with this movie. Because yes, I did see this at an early access 4DX screening. So I'm definitely excited to talk about this sequel to Ghostbusters 1984. When a single mom and her two kids arrive in a small town, they begin to discover their connection to the original Ghostbusters and the secret legacy their grandfather left behind. This movie is directed by Jason Reitman. This movie stars McKenna Grace, Finn Wolfhard, Carrie Coon, Paul Rudd, Logan Kim, and Celeste O'Connor. So I'm a huge fan of the Ghostbusters. Please check out my reviews I've been doing this week for Ghostbusters 1984, Ghostbusters 2, Ghostbusters 2016, leading up to Ghostbusters Afterlife. So after seeing this, I will say that I think you should watch Ghostbusters 1984 at least before going into this, just to refresh your memory on it. I think you do get more out of this movie as a fan of the first one, as a fan of the series, but also with a refreshed memory of the first one. So this movie is a throwback to Steven Spielberg's older days. It just felt like that, with these younger actors in a small town trying to solve a mystery, getting into all these kind of different supernatural or paranormal adventures. I'm also a big fan of the Reitmans. Ivan Reitman directed the first Ghostbusters and Ghostbusters 2, and now his son, Jason Reitman, has taken the reins and has written and directed this one. And I gotta say, I think that the directing here is really good. There are some amazing shots. I think really good use of cinematography here. There's this one shot in particular that just stands out of my mind, and honestly, I would not mind like a framed photo of it. They're driving the Ecto-1 and they're trying to catch this ghost. It's a shot from a little far away kind of landscape with the sun setting, the car driving, the beam shooting from the car, and the ghost. So I thought that was a really cool shot. One of the best, and there were of course other shots that were really cool. Really good effects, really good practical effects, really good visual effects, really good CGI here. I really liked the CGI and the effects here. I thought it looked great, and that just goes hand in hand with Jason Reitman's directing, with the special effects team, and with the acting, because you gotta think that when it is CGI, actors have to act as if this thing is there. So I really enjoyed all those aspects of this film. This is a very fun adventure film. I had a blast watching this. There were times when a smile wouldn't leave my face for a while. It is funny. I will say not all the humor lands. I really enjoy McKenna Grace's performance. I think that she is the standout of this film. At first I thought I was gonna be annoyed by her and Finn Wolfhard's character. But that they really started to grow on me. But yeah, no, McKenna Grace as Phoebe was just, she did a really good job. I mean, I would say she's the lead of this film. She has a bright future ahead of her, and I've seen her in other stuff, and she's just a really good actress, I think. She brings such life to this character. You believe that this girl is a smart, smart scientist. I think that that was really important for a character like this. An awkward, yet really witty, really smart person. And then you have Finn Wolfhard as her older brother. I think that he did a really good job here. I was really excited to see him in this, and I think that he did do a good job. And then, of course, you have Carrie Coon and Paul Rudd, who had really good chemistry, and they did add, you know, a lot of goodness to this film, I think. Paul Rudd was really funny. He's always funny. But no, I really think the cast did a great job. Logan Kim as podcast, because he, throughout the film, he's like making a podcast, so he'll have really funny lines. I think he's a really talented young kid actor as well. He was funny. Some of his stuff did not land. Some of the comedy in general, like I said, did not land, but a lot of it did. I did get some chuckles here and there, some smiles here and there. He was a really good character. I think Celeste O'Connor is lucky. He was kind of underused. I don't know what they would have really done with her more, but she's good. She's a good actress. I just thought she was a little underused here. But this cast, I think, just the ensemble, I think that they did a phenomenal job. The writing here and there has issues, I will say. I think that there's a lot of good stuff here. I really like the story. I think that it's kind of an epic scale story. A really cool story, but there's stuff here and there. There are some training things where they are training with the gadgets and stuff, but these people, these kids, and even if they were adults, they knew how to work some of these gadgets, like, right away, especially when they're driving the car. It was kind of an accident how Phoebe realized that there was a shooter seat that pops out of the car. But then, you know, Logan Kim's character, podcast, he found a way to open a ramp underneath the car, and then his little remote control car went under. I don't know how he knew how to, that would happen, and then they knew how to work the proton packs, but there was a training part with that, but still, they didn't have that much training with these gadgets, or none at all. Some cuteness that was in the trailer are the little Stay Puft Marshmallow Men. They are really adorable here. They're funny. They get into a lot of funny hijinks during their grocery store scene and a little bit after. I think you'll enjoy them. Some people might see them as, like, too much of a gimmick, or, like, you know, too much, too over the top. I really enjoyed them. You know, another negative, though, with that kind of dodgy writing with, like, learning the gadgets and stuff, that's really where I found the fault with the writing. Perhaps there's too much references and Easter eggs to the original. To some people. For me, it didn't take me out of the film. It didn't get too much for me. I could see a lot of people being like, as a matter of fact, when I was walking out of the theater, I did hear people be like, oh, there were too much references. But for a lot of the time, it made sense because this is a continuation of that story. What happened in that story really connects to this story. It was a fun movie, and I really enjoyed the third act. I thought the third act was epic. Oh, it was so well done. Like I said, the visuals look great. The acting was great. The directing was great. I really enjoyed this third act. I do also recommend not watching the final trailer if you haven't already. All in all, this is a fun movie. I'm about to talk about 4DX. If you want to know more about 4DX, you can check out my video, What is 4DX? I'll get more to this into my spoiler review, but it paid great homage to the original, and it was such a great continuation and just a really good and enjoyable sequel. Okay, so the 4DX experience here, it is fun, especially when they're driving in the Ecto-1. It is a very, very fun experience to see this in 4DX. The seats were moving everywhere. There was a time when I thought I was gonna fly right out of the seats. This was one of the more fun times with 4DX. I mean, I've always had a fun time pretty much, but it was really cool. And then, you know, the wind's blowing, like when ghosts are flying around, and when the car's driving, even when they're driving in general, you know, it's just the seats are moving as if you're in the car with them, and you feel the wind blowing, and then cool effects with the lighting in the theater would flash at certain times. There isn't much water stuff here. There is one scene, I think, with water, with a fire hydrant. I thought that was pretty fun. But yeah, no, the car scene, especially when they're driving and trying to catch the one ghost, that was a very, very fun time in the theater. Everyone was reacting to it in my theater. We really enjoyed this 4DX experience. So I would say yes, it is worth seeing in 4DX. There's downtime in this movie. Nothing much is happening with the seats or the auditorium. But I do think when it is happening, it's such a blast. If you're interested in 4DX, you haven't tried it yet, I do recommend trying it. Or if you have tried it and you've liked it, I do recommend trying it for Ghostbusters Afterlife. So please, before I get to my rating, please comment down below. What did you think of Ghostbusters Afterlife? Where does it stack up with the other Ghostbuster films? Let me know down in the comments. Please blow up that comment section. But what would I give Ghostbusters Afterlife? Ghostbusters Afterlife gets an 8.5 out of 10 from me. That's an 8.5 out of 10 for Ghostbusters Afterlife. If you liked what you've seen here, you're going to like something else. So please click around here to see something else. Please like this video, comment on this video, share this video with the Ghostbusters fans in your life. Hit that notification bell, subscribe, and come to the Upside Dan.